Okay, it looks like I'm online now. I'm not sure if it's Twitch or if it's OBS, but one or the other, for whatever reason, I hit the stream button on OBS and it doesn't actually stream. And I just kind of sit here for like, you know, 10 minutes wondering, wait, am I actually online or not? Oh, it's quite a mess. Okay. Looks like everything's fixed now. So it's been a while since I've done City Skylines. And, you know, my afternoons have mostly been... And my mornings/afternoons, they've mostly been Morrowind. And then I took a little break from Morrowind to do UN Squadron a few days ago. But, you know, I think I'm going to take another break from Morrowind just to do a little city building, because it's been a while. And you know what? I think RPGs were just a little bit, the RPGs were just a little bit too intense. You know, RPGs are just so darn fast, okay? Just, you know, a mile-a-minute gameplay. You can't keep up, so we gotta bring the pace back a little bit. You know, we gotta reel it in. And we have to, you know, just do a little city building to kind of calm down. Okay. So the last cities I had running was Beartopia and Simtopia. And I liked them, but... The last time I played, I was enlightened to civilian paths, pedestrian paths. And that blew my mind, and now I really want to roll with it, so I'm going to make a new map, and I'm going to start up just, I don't know, just kind of exploring what I can do with pedestrian paths. I mean, I feel like I can do a whole lot of really dumb things with pedestrian paths, so I'm just going to go ahead and see what I can get out of it. Now, what kind of a map would be the best, right, for pedestrians? Well, islands. I think islands might be really good for that, but at the same time, I haven't really experimented with the snowy maps, but let's see, I'm looking for a map that I haven't done in a while. Like, there's got to be a map I haven't really played yet. I don't know, we got so many good options here. I think maybe the Grand River. I mean, just thinking about it, the Grand River, like, oh my god, you could build a giant dam and just completely mess that up. It'd be great. Let's see, we got Green Plains, River Run. Let's see, what were the maps that I used last time? I'm trying to see, I can't really tell. Like, Beartopia, that was a custom map. Simtopia, I'm not really sure which map that is. Oh, hey, I see a burn. I see a burn already. Twitch has been acting up on me lately. Like, when I go to, like, to check my channel and see what's going on Twitch. Like, it's... Like, half the time, it seems like I stream... Like, you know, I hit the button on OBS, and then it doesn't do anything. So, like, the light's green, but I'm not actually online. And, I have to keep double-checking now to make sure that I'm actually online. So I'm not sure if that's OBS or if that's Twitch being a problem. Two Rivers, okay. Two Rivers, that's the map that that Simtopia is on. So what would be... Let's go with Islands, I like that one. And let's see, what is the city going to be called? I don't know. How about just the Stremland for right now? We'll come up with a better, more original name for it later. All right, and let's get it going. But yeah, I know you're all disappointed. No Morrowind, but I've been doing Morrowind so much, like around noon. I just wanted to reel things back in and, you know, just take it easy. And just, because, you know, RPGs are too hectic. So I wanted to take it easy with a little city building. Okay, what have I got to work with here? Let's take a look at the overhead. We got lots of water. Alright, so we have lots of water over here. Got a nice island right over here. You know, this is less islands and it's more just lots of rivers and a lake. That's really more what this is. Okay. Let's get things started. Now I'm going to try to make use of pedestrian paths this time around. I just do that to unlock roads. Okay, so I got a 6-lane road. I got a 6-lane one way. Alright. So how do I want to play this? You know, I'm gonna kind of mix it up from how I normally build. Well, I'm gonna build exactly how I normally build, but I'm gonna do a slight difference this time around. So I'm gonna make like one road that just goes like this. Okay. So that's gonna be my highway connection. Yeah, just it loops around. You got a nice little road right here. Okay, so now I have to think how I want to do this. Like, I have to do this in a way that traffic isn't going to completely back up. Alright. Oh, that's some farmland right there, isn't it? It is. Okay, so I want to play around with pathing. And for that, I'm going to need to keep the residential areas separate from everything else. I'm not really too sure how I want to work that. Here's what I think I'm going to do. I am going to put... Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put the industrial area, I'm going to put that, like, right over here. Yeah, we're going to have, like, tons of industry right around here. Let's build that out. And then we're going to have the commercial... Well, hold on a minute. I want to try something a little different, and I want to have the residential area completely sectioned off from the rest of the city, and that might seem a little weird, but just kind of roll with it, okay? Like, roll with it for a second. Although, wait, yeah, they need to be able to actually get in there. Okay, yeah. Scrap that idea. Now, completely, yeah, that was a bad idea. That was a terrible idea. Okay, let's have the residential area kind of going off from here. Stretch that out right there. Okay. Now this is poor planning already on my part. All right, and I'm just gonna have some civilian housing right around here. Then we're gonna have the industry. All the industry is gonna be like right out here. I think I want to build it kind of... I'm going for a different building pattern this time than what I normally go with. Okay, so I'm going to build all of my industry like kind of right around here, like this. And then commercial. Where do I want the commercial stuff to be? And that is a question. Well, I'll work on it. It's a question that I will try to figure out an answer to as I build. I just want to get some residential zoned off here. Okay. And get some industrial right along here. And I'll figure out commercial as I go. So next up we got power. Alright, and we can build right here. That'll be nice. Or do I want to go with a coal power plant? I mean, coal is pretty nice. Let's make the coal power plant right here. And we'll kind of stretch the power lines right there. Alright. And then the commercial. I want all the commercial stuff to be kind of sectioned off to its own. Yeah, no, we'll work on commercial after we get this figured out. So, when it comes to water, we'll go ahead and pump right here. Well, hold on. Yeah, let's go ahead and pump the water from right here. And then let's, pump it from there, and then dump it right there. Okay, and it's already connected to the power grid, or it should be, anyway. The moment that the housing starts stretching out, we'll kind of get there. Let me go ahead and save. Alright, so while I'm waiting on the housing to kind of build out, while I'm waiting on that, so, complete and total aside, doesn't have to do... It's nothing that has to do with anything. So I was thinking about playing something. I got to thinking about playing something that I haven't played in a long time. It's one of those online games, I know. But I kinda got to thinking about Terra Online, which anyone who is familiar with that game, you're probably immediately rolling your eyes at me. I can feel it. Now, I guess let me say my piece on it. I always thought it was a fun game. Like, I enjoyed playing it. I acknowledge that it wasn't the best game, but it was a fun game. And as for all of the, I don't know, what's the term for it? Fan service, cheesecake, I don't know. But as for all of that, I have no problems with that whatsoever. Never have, never will have a problem with that. As a matter of fact, I always like to make really kind of goofy, over-the-top characters in that, along that theme. So yeah, I had no problems with that. But it was the gameplay that always got me interested, and the gameplay of Terra Online was... Well, it was something. I liked the giant monsters, the big monsters. I forget what they were called. There was a term for them in the game, but I forget what it was. The big monsters. They were always so much fun to fight. Like I loved fighting the big monsters, especially. My character back in the day was a warrior, and I loved tanking with that. Because it relied entirely on evasion. But yeah, like the regular monsters, like the little ones, those weren't too terribly fun. But the big ones, that's where it was at. So I had gotten to thinking about installing it again. You know, getting back into it. And I don't know. It was one of those things where I had the thought to do it, but at the same time, I kind of immediately thought against it and thought, that's probably not a good idea. Because look, as fun as the gameplay might have been, the game wasn't really all that well made. I think that was the biggest issue with it, was that the game just wasn't really very quality. I mean, it had that sort of, you know, farmed out Korean MMO type of feel to it. And for the most part, that's not a good feel. That's not something you want in your game. Yeah, but if we want to go further down the shame hole, right? So another game that I liked a lot, you know, a long time ago, was another one was Scarlet Blade, and I know, again, I can feel the eye rolls, I can feel them, but the game was actually kind of fun, and I liked the art style. Like, what can I say? I liked the art style, okay? So do I want to put some commercial down here? I might just have to. I don't know. Nope, not enough money. Well, I'm gonna have to go ahead and... Yeah, I'm gonna have to go ahead and put some commerce in here. Now, hopefully that solves their problems. Let's fast forward. So, boom. Commerce. Oh, we're a little hamlet now. That's nice. Okay, let's go ahead and pause. Let's get the water supply all figured out. And I'm gonna go ahead and preemptively put some pipes over there. So I wanted to designate a whole area specifically just for, you know, just for commercial type of stuff. Now let's see, if I were to designate an area, like, oh, I don't know, let's say over here, right? Like, just theoretically, if I were to put some commercial stuff over here. Trying to make this look kind of appealing. Or at least interesting. Okay. So let's just slap a whole bunch of commerce right over in here. Alright, just commercial all around. And I'm not gonna connect it. I am not going to connect it right there. I'm gonna get rid of all this. Alright. Okay, so I'm gonna get rid of that. Gonna get some piping to go over here. They're gonna need power. Let's stretch some power lines right over here. Just get a little bit of that power right there. Okay. And now I want to make some civilian paths. Okay, I want to make some pathways for civilians and civilians only to get over there. So, oh look, I have to have a higher population. Okay. Well, let's work on that later then. Okay. Like we'll work on getting, you know, work on getting that all fixed out later. For right now, we'll allow the civilians, the residential population, to get over here. For now. And then once we have a higher population, we'll get that sorted out, and we'll make it so they can only get to the commercial areas by way of pedestrian path. This might be a horrible, like, I feel like this might just be a terrible, horrible decision. Like, planning my city out around pedestrian paths, this might be a really bad idea. Or it just might be a really awesome idea. I don't know. Hey, we're in the green. And then it starts storming. I'm just kind of watching, like, to see how the traffic goes. So here's my plan, okay? Like, the big plan is to have the residential area to be completely kind of separated off from everything else. And what I want to do is I want to have the residential area. I want them to only be able to get around by pedestrian paths. Okay, like, that is the only way they can get around ever. And that might be a really bad idea. I can feel it. I can feel how bad this is gonna go down. At the same time, I feel like it'd be really fun. You know, just as an experiment and just as something different. You know, like, just to kind of try something different with how I normally build. And yes, I'm building in a very strange pattern. That's how I like it. I don't know what more to say. It's how I like to build. Okay. Residential demand is very low. Now I can kind of fix that with, I was about to say, with parks and plazas, but I can't do that just yet. I don't have any monuments or anything. Oh, I do have a monument. A statue of industry. Don't really have a good place to put it, though. That's unfortunate. Okay, we can build this. How much? Yeah, it's got kind of an upkeep on it. I don't know. Now, a statue of shopping. I love that one. Yeah, let's go with the statue of shopping. That seems like something very consumerist. Let's put that right in over here. There we go. It makes people happy. So yeah, the statue of shopping. All hail the iPhone. I've got policies now, that's great. How's electricity, water? Okay, everything's doing good. Garbage is gonna be a problem, eventually. And I'm wondering how I can, like, okay, how can I get garbage services? Like, how can I get services to every part of the city, yet have the residential, okay, so I'm looking down here, and I feel like the traffic is gonna get a little bit hectic over here. Let's fast forward. So there's a very low demand for residential and commercial right now. It's city's building out very slowly. I do love watching it build up, but oh, look at this. We've already got fires. Fires are already a problem. People kind of want to move in over here. That's good. Let's go ahead and get some services around here. Also, let me fix my roads real quick. So, and this right here, I think what I actually want to do is I want to make a road going this way. There we go. And let's just get rid of that. Okay. Oh, we're a tiny town now. Excellent. So let me think about, city services. There's a lot of fires going on, so let's get a fire department right here. Let's get a police department. Put that right over here. And let's put an elementary school, again, right there. So that's all your basic services. Oh yeah, there's also a hospital, but they can wait on that. Alright, a little bit of education. It'll make... just a little education goes a long way in this game. And they've got all the basic services to keep the city from just burning down. Okay, let's go ahead and plan out some more. Now, look, already they want garbage management, and I can't blame them. The city is a mess. Of course they want garbage management. Okay, what I'm gonna do here... No, I want to keep that empty. Okay, that needs to stay empty right there. The residential area, I'm gonna try to expand that a little bit. Maybe right like this. Man, that's really uneven. It's really, really uneven. Maybe if I trim things back a little bit right there. Oh, that makes everybody lose power. Well, I knew that was gonna happen, but I'm hoping that if I can, if they grow out a little bit right here, I'm hoping that'll solve the problem. Got plenty commercial, okay. Alright, no, I'm gonna have to build this back out right here. Maybe not. We're not in the red yet. See, look at me, I'm thinking, they don't have electricity, but we're not in debt, so... I was hoping they'd just kind of expand on their own. Yeah, see, look, they're growing on their own. Eventually, they'll grow out here, and it'll connect. But let's not sabotage ourselves so quickly, so... There we go. That solves that problem. Now, garbage. Garbage is gonna be a problem very soon. I hate to use these. I would much prefer to use an incineration plant. That's what I would prefer to use. However, you need to have a much higher population in order to do that sort of thing. So where do I wanna... It's gonna look ugly. It's gonna look ugly, it's gonna be ugly, but that's what we have to do. Alright, so garbage trucks. Garbage trucks away. I just noticed, the lighting kind of makes things... There's like a distortion effect going on with this. I never really noticed that before. Okay, so there's almost no demand for residential. I feel like if I get more city services in here, I think that'll change. You know, just make the city look nicer, and I think people will want to actually live here. Eventually. Oh, not enough money. Hold on, I'll have enough money in a second. Just let it happen. There we go. And just plop a little more industry right over here. I want to be careful. I don't want to build it out too much. Like right there. That's good. Ah, thanks. I think it's coming along pretty crappily, actually, but yeah, it's nice that you think so. It's nice that you think it looks great. The main problem I'm having is that there's certain things I want to do with this city, but I can't do them just yet. So what I want to do is I want to make this city based around pathways. So what I mean by that is the pedestrian paths, you know, like those little pathways you can just build wherever. That's what I want to base the whole city on. So like eventually, what I want this city to look like eventually is I want the residential areas, like right here, I want the residential areas to be completely self-contained, and then I want to create some elevated walkways, just pedestrian walkways, and I want those elevated paths, I want those to go like out to the, you know, to the commercial area here and to the industrial area. So basically, I want for there to be no... Essentially, I want for there to be no pedestrian traffic, like, on the roads. I mean, no civilian traffic on the roads. And so basically, the only traffic that would be on the roads is like, trucks. You know, things that have to carry industrial goods around. Oh, I don't have enough power. I was kind of wondering, I was like, wait, everything's hooked up, why is... Oh no, we just don't have enough power. Well, that's bad. Yeah, somebody told... See, like, I was, a couple of people enlightened me on pedestrian pathways the last time I did City Skylines, and I kind of tinkered around with them, and I thought, wow, this actually looks pretty cool. But my city just wasn't built for it. Like, my city was not really made with that kind of thing in mind. So this time around, I'm building my entire city with civilian pathways in mind. Okay, so I've got this area right here. It's coming along nicely. I like it. Can I purchase some land? Yes, I can. Okay. So I want to make another residential area. I think right over here. That's a good spot. I don't really have the money for it, but we'll work on that. Let's go ahead and get a little bit more space here. If I can make it work. The game likes to fight me. There we go. And just stretch that right. Oh wait, stretch it right like. Well, this is interesting. My roads are kind of crooked right here, but it's just this one. I'm not really sure what's up with that. There, now it's fixed. Yeah, it just temporarily displaced a bunch of people, but that's okay. I'm the mayor, I can do that sort of thing. So, when it comes to me and City Skylines, I like to build sort of less than conventional cities. Now, you always kind of get stuck with the grid patterns because, you know, the game wants you to reach certain milestones, and it's hard to hit those when you're building a really weird-looking city. But once I have the freedom to kind of build how I want to build, what I tend to do is I tend to actually make my cities, I tend to make lots of kind of elevated things. Like, I love elevated train tracks, elevated roads, and not just elevated, but I like to make them kind of, you know, twist around on themselves and do corkscrews and all, you know, dumb stuff like that. You know, not very efficient, but it looks fun. Yeah, that's the thing. I never did either. Like, I never actually thought about using paths before somebody mentioned it to me. And I want to make use of them now. But the problem is, like, first off, you have to unlock them. And they're right over here. So, yeah, I've unlocked them, but I can't really do much with them just yet. Like, eventually I'll do something with it. For right now, we're in the sort of pre-planning phase, where I'm just getting my city laid out in a way that is conducive to what I'm going to be doing. Okay, let's see, let's work on stretching some road out. Okay, I'm gonna make another sort of civilian area, and I'm gonna make it right around here. Like, right there. And again, I'm laying them out so far away from each other because I actually want to, like, I want to have all this connected via elevated pathways, eventually. Like, I mean, for right now, I'm gonna have to use regular roads, but that will all change in due time. How do I want to lay this out? Let's make it interesting, actually. There we go. And let's go ahead and get some power going. And stretch that over there. Get some water lines going over here. Just planning all that out in advance. And there. So everything should be good. We'll have a whole new residential district ready to go. Also, I might want to turn this into farmland. Let's see if I can do that. Yes, I can. Okay, let's make a district. So it's gonna just district all of this out right here. Actually, I'm gonna plan it to be rather large. Okay. Let's take a look. I wanna see, where's my resources? Natural resources. Yes, there's lots of fertile land over here, so. So what I wanna do is I wanna convert all these polluting factories. I want to convert them all into farmland. There we go. And let's see, if I'm going to do that, I probably want to relocate the power plants. Because the power plants are only going to get in the way of the farming. So let's move the power plants. We're going to move them right over here. Right next to each other, as a matter of fact. Well, like right about there. That's where they can be. And we'll just stretch this out like that. There we go. Okay, it should all come together now. Well, very slowly it should all come together because I have to. Oh. Yeah, I have to replace all of these polluting factories with farms. So the last city that I built, the last one that I built, I actually, like, I've been kind of experimenting with building my cities differently from how I normally build them. And in my last city, what I did was I built residential and commercial and industrial. I built them all together, as in, like, okay, how I would build in my other city is, like, for instance, I'd have my streets set up like this, and like in this area I'd put like residential, and then in the kind of area right next to it I'd put industrial, then I'd put residential again. And then, like, all along the side, it would be commercial. Now, the only way that works is if you use farmland. So basically, if you use farming as your industry, you can actually put the industry right next to the residential, and it doesn't cause any problems at all. And as a matter of fact, when you build your... Like, what I found out with that experiment is that when you build your residential, industrial, and commercial all together, there's almost no civilian traffic. Okay, like, all the civilians, they just walk to their destination. Because everything they need is right next to where they live. So the only real traffic that you have is the industrial and commercial traffic. So I found that actually worked out really, really well. Yeah, that's kind of like how I tend to lay my cities out. Like, I tend to put all the garbage and the power production, I tend to put it all right in one place, usually right in the center of the city. But hey, it's efficient because, see, the garbage trucks, they have easy access to go wherever they have to go, right? They can go anywhere in the city they want from right here in the middle. Okay, we need more commercials, so let me go ahead and build that out some more. Yeah, right about there is good. Squeeze a road in there. It's a little bit uneven, but you know, I don't mind it. Make some little roads off to the side here. Okay. And commercial. More commercial. More commerce. Gotta have it. Go ahead and build that out right here. Now, eventually, I'm gonna get rid of this, like, this little road right here. I'm eventually gonna get rid of it. And I'm gonna replace it with just a pedestrian path. But like I said before, we're not ready for that yet. Okay, the city would collapse if we tried to make everything pedestrian path only. Like, right now. Eventually, though. Eventually, it will work. Just not yet. Let's go ahead and make some commercial all along here. Make sure everybody's got water. Planning out for the future. Okay, how's this area over here doing? Not all that well. Like, I planned out this whole area for residential, but they're not really making use of it. That's a shame. Now the farmland. Farmland isn't coming along so well. Now, why is this giant industrial building? Like, why is this here? It shouldn't be there. Yeah, that thing's gotta go. Hold on, let's, I always forget, delete key doesn't work in this. There we go. Alright, so the land is a little bit polluted right now, but once the land unpollutes, this is all gonna be prime farmland, okay? Just the best farmland you could ever want, right up in here. Let's maybe extend the road a little bit. Oh, not enough money. Let's wait for that money to come in. Now, the next thing I can work on is happiness, because the more happy everyone is, the more I can tax them. So yeah, look at this. They have no happiness, just none. Everybody's miserable. So let's kind of fix that. What can I put in here? I could give them bouncy castles. Oh, hold on a minute. Okay, so that is an upkeep of 48 a week. What's the cheapest thing I can do? Okay, so the small park, that actually pretty low upkeep. Like, almost no upkeep at all. So let's go ahead and put a park. those parks like right about where they'll do the most good. So, like one right there. One right there. And one right over here in the corner. It's always hard to find, like, there we go, find the sweet spot to build it. Okay. And let's make sure that the commercial area, make sure they're happy too. And let's go ahead and plan out in advance. Let's get some happiness boosters right up in here. There we go. Look at that. Everybody's happy. You know, I had to bulldoze some people's houses to build those parks, but you know, everybody's happy. Don't worry about it. Okay, everything looks good. Everything looks good. So happiness. So now that everyone's happy, I can go into my budget panel and I can start taxing people like about 11%. So let's move them taxes up across the board to 11%. Okay. So yeah, see, look. Now I'm making more money. Awesome. Things are looking a little foggy over here. That's normal. Okay, the residential. Hey, look at that, the residential area. It's all filling out. People are doing great. There's a couple of fires, but for the most part, everything is great. A little firehouse over there. I mean, hey, now that I'm making more money off of the city, I can probably stand to have more police and more services and all that. Okay, they got fire. Maybe a hospital. Maybe, just maybe they want a hospital. Oh, we don't have water. That's a problem. Let's pump a little bit more. Okay, so we, you know, for everything that we pump, well, you know, what you pump, you also must dump. That's the rules. But oh, hey, look at this. I have the option to pump our sludge out into the ocean now. I am gonna take that. I'm gonna take that option. So let's see, we're just gonna go ahead and make that right there. And you know what? Look, I'm gonna put a nice clean windmill right there to power it. And now I don't have to worry about, you know, we don't have to worry about messy power lines or anything like that. You just get rid of that. Awesome. So yeah, now, because you might notice that there's a lot of brown in the river here. Well, see, now we're getting rid of that. Okay, there is no more brown coming from that, from that river. Now it's all coming from here. Let me just connect it. There we go. So now it's all coming out right here, and it's harmlessly being pumped out into the ocean. But look, we don't drink ocean water, okay? We don't drink salt water here in this city. So as long as it's not the drinking water, we're good. Oh yeah, the temperature? Well, that's a relatively new thing. I mean, there was that whole expansion that added snowy maps, and you know, you have to deal with all the problems associated with winter weather. Well, with that little expansion, they also added a free update, and one of the things in that is you have to worry about the temperature. So yeah, basically the colder that it gets, like the more the city uses electricity. So like if it gets really cold, then people are, you know, they're cranking up the heating, and that puts a bigger strain on the city's power supply. There's a lot of mechanics have been added to this game over time. Yeah, harmless. No, look, see, I said harmlessly, okay? As your mayor, would I lie to you? Alright, we need more electricity. Water is good, garbage is good. Let's get a little more electricity going on in here. Could put a windmill right here, but windmills aren't gonna cut it. Let's go for that coal power. There we go. Yeah, there's lots of changes. I haven't really played around with the winter maps in this game. It's like the problem that comes with the winter maps is that you have to plow the road. Like, basically, you have to set up city services to, like you have to set up snow plows, and you have to set up heating pipes, like, to, you know, to get heat to the city. There's a lot of extra challenges, and it makes the game a lot harder when you're first starting off. Oh, I need a cemetery. Okay, let's put it right, yeah, let's put it right there. And just put the cemetery right next to the coal plant and the garbage dump. And there's also... there's some changes coming to this game, like, soon. And they're changes that I've been wanting for so long. So, like, I don't know if you know, but there's a whole, like... there's a whole disasters expansion coming. Like, it's a whole expansion devoted to disasters. And I am pumped for that. Like, that's something I've been waiting for. Like, since day one, I have been waiting for a disasters expansion to come out. Get some more industry over here and just fill all that out. There we go. Oh wait, make sure it's hold on, let's make sure that's a districted. It's got to be in the district. All right, add some water. Yeah, I'm so looking forward to this disasters expansion. Like, I want some alien invasions, I want some meteors, I want my city to get fucked up. And at the same time, I also want for there to be good, like, rapid responses and stuff like that. Yeah, I want for that to be a part of the gameplay as well. And hey, look, all the farms, they got cows. And it's a weird thing, so, like, look, I don't look at the Steam forums very often because, well, they're kind of cancer, okay? But, for some reason, like, for whatever reason, a lot of people, they're like, I thought people would be really excited, because I am, like, I'm really excited about the Disasters expansion coming, but a lot of people, they're like, oh no, nobody asked for this. Nobody wants disasters in their city builder game. And it's just, I don't know, it's weird. Like, a lot of people apparently don't want disasters in their game. I don't really understand why. I don't get the logic behind that. I mean, at least for me, and maybe I'm a little bit, I don't know, maybe I'm a little bit immature that way, but for me, half the fun of city builder games is to, like, once you've built up this amazing, beautiful, this beautiful cityscape, right? Well, for me, one of the most fun things to do is to then just completely destroy it. Just completely wreck your beautiful city. You know, just to watch it go up in flames. That's half the fun to me, and I don't know, maybe that's not how most people play their city builders, but that's how I like them. God damn, we need power. Okay, no, we're good. We're good for power. Oh, there's a lot of abandoned buildings here. And yeah, that's my thoughts. Like my thought on disasters are, I mean, it's realistic. I mean, well, to an extent, but even, you know, even the more silly ones, what I like about disasters is I've always liked how it forces you. Like, basically, it forces you to kind of, to really work with your city's resources and to, like, get the situation under control. You know, like, to get a handle on the situation and then to rebuild afterwards. I feel like it puts a really good strain on your city management overall. And I don't know. But a lot of people, the way they look at it is, you know, I spent all this time building up this city. I already have a delete button. You know, if I wanted to destroy it, I'd just hit the delete button. Like, I just feel there's no good way to convey exactly how that's wrong. But it's just wrong. And now everyone just stomps on their hat in anger and storms out of the stream. Yeah, exactly. It makes things more interesting, too. Yeah, it makes it more realistic, it makes it more interesting. And it's fun. God damn, it's fun. I can't help it. Like, in SimCity Societies, I mean, half the fun of that is to just watch my city get destroyed by aliens or something like that. I mean, it's so much fun. Man, this area is getting polluted. Okay, let's build a couple more farms. Just a few. All right, I got enough space for that. Excellent. Okay, power. Come on, I don't have enough power. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Get that oil power plant. That's what I need. Yeah, look at that. That's the good stuff right there. Okay, now we're making all the power that we need. And let's just kind of, yeah, get that over there. Everybody went out of power for a second. Oh, traffic. Traffic is jamming up. Oh, we got pipeline problems now. What's the problem with my pipeline? Oh, I see. So the problem with the pipeline now is we're just not making enough water. There we go. More water. And just harmlessly pump, you know, just again, harmlessly pump some sludge out into the ocean. There we go. Look at that. It's, you know, it harmlessly goes out there into the ocean, where the only thing that has to worry about it is the fish. Everything's getting abandoned over here. Okay, I think I can go ahead and start making some pedestrian paths. I feel like I've got the money for it now. It's perfectly harmless. Don't worry about it. Let's try some pathways. So, we're gonna go with a pavement path. Now, where do I want to start it? Start it right here. Wait, nope. Right there. Let's elevate it up. This is gonna be tricky. Gonna be quite tricky to come up with a good pathway. Okay, that's too steep. Now I have to think how I want to build this, okay? And there's a right way and a wrong way to build a pathway. Hmm. I can't quite do that. I can do this, though. Hold on. Alright, look at that. I know it looks kind of ugly right now, but no, I got a plan. Okay, I've got a plan. Alright, so I want that to go down over here. Kind of stretch out there. And then I want it to come down. Let's see, I want it to come down like somewhere right around here. Oh, it's gonna be hard to fit it. There we go. Alright, so that's the first pathway. Alright, like, so it goes from the residential area over here to the commercial area. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna get rid of the connector. Alright, so there's no connector between those two places right now. So people wanting to go from point A to point B, they get to walk. They get to walk over this nice walkway here. Now, it'll look nicer as the city starts to get built up. It will slowly begin to look nicer, okay? Oh yeah, I always forget about building things underground. I really do. I always forget about making things under the ground, but I love elevated pathways so much. Like, I love them. And I've said it before, I love making elevated roads and railroads and pathways. And the reason I like that, so you can kind of tell, like, you know, how old I am, because, like, the reason I love this is because for the longest time, when it comes to city builders, we just didn't have the option. You know, we just did not have the option to make, like, you know, I mean, for the longest time, you couldn't even make diagonal roads, okay? So finally, we get all these options when it comes to making curvy roads and railroads and pathways and then elevating them and making them loop up and under and over buildings. And, you know, now that we have all the options, it's like, well, come on, gotta use them. Yeah, that incline. No, look, it's fine. It's good exercise, okay? Like, this pathway, like, look at it, this pathway is amazing exercise. You know, don't be lazy, alright? Don't be lazy. And I love watching all the little people walking on these elevated pathways. Okay, now that I've done that, we're gonna take this a couple steps further, okay? That was phase one. So now, let's try to get our pathways. Let's try to make our pathways kind of go. Let's see. Let's try to make our paths. Let's try to make them extend. I can't really go this way because I can't. Like, I can't go over the power plant. But I could move the power plant right here. That's what I can do. Can I go over? Now look at this. I should be able to go over the garbage dump. Why? I can't go over the garbage dump. Okay, that's a problem. So there will be no going over the garbage. Curved pathways, maybe? No, that's not gonna work, is it? That's not gonna work. Well, damn. I can't do that. Hold on. It's not over yet, alright? It's not over yet. Let me think about how I want to do this. Okay, so if I can't move the garbage dump, then I'm gonna move everything else. Yeah, let's put everything right over here. And I think I actually have a little too much power, don't I? Yeah, I got too much power, so There we go. Now, I've got a plan here. Got a plan. So let's take this. Let's curve this around, like, right there. Let's take it on a straight path, right this way. I want to keep it close to the road. And then I want to use a curved path. And if I can, like, maybe take it like this. Maybe, like right like that. There we go. This is a mess. It's a wonderful mess. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Well, I can still do that. I can still kind of take it like this. That works. That works. So we're gonna take that, bring it around here, go straight over top of all these houses. You know, those houses don't matter. And let's bring it down. Okay, let's bring it down so it comes to the road. And I could probably make it loop around on itself, but we won't do that. There we go. Okay, so yeah, now this residential area is connected. Looks like the water, water is an issue over here. I can't forget the city. All right, so now we've got a pathway which goes from residential to residential, and it all goes into the commercial area, okay? And people are using it, okay? Like, you look at the little pathway, people are in fact using this giant pathway that extends, like, way, way further than it should. But people are using it. Now, the question is, are people going to use it over on this side of the city? Are they going to use it or not? Well, time will tell. In the meantime, there's a high demand for residential and a little bit of industrial, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to stretch out some more. Yeah, just a little more space for residential. Right along there. And I'm not going to build too much. Not yet, anyway. I really want to see someone use this pathway. I mean, I really want to see it. I really want to see someone walk all the way. Just all the way over here. Oh, there's a break. Well, no wonder. No wonder nobody's using it. There's a break in the path. Let me fix that. This is weird. Hold on, how do I fix this? There. Okay, so the path, it's fixed now, right? Yeah. Okay, I want to see someone use this thing. I just want to see one guy walking, like, all the way from the residential area to the commercial area. I just want to see it. Just once. Now, when it comes to policies, let me think. So are there any policies that might encourage people not to drive? So I could encourage biking. Okay, I could encourage biking. Let's try that. And as a matter of fact, let's make it a citywide thing. So, like, in the whole city, biking is encouraged. I'm not really sure how much of an effect that's gonna have. But I'd like to see it nonetheless. Oh, we got new buildings. Oh, yeah, right. I can make a road maintenance department now. It'll make roads go a little bit faster. I don't think I need that. Not yet, anyway. So, we're encouraging biking. We've got these pathways set up, going from one area to the next. I can make a big police station now. That's nice. We got power, we got water, and we've got garbage. Lots of it. Oh, I didn't mean to build that. I really didn't mean to build that. Well, look, if I'm gonna have one, let's plop it right down here. Okay, so I want to try something, and I want to see how badly this fucks up the city. So here's what I'm going to do. Alright, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make another pathway that extends into the industrial area. Okay? So let's see. Like, let's put one right here. And let's see. Let's kind of... what do we want to do? I could take it right here. That's gonna get rid of some power lines. That's not good, but let's go ahead and let's extend the, let's just extend that all the way over here. Oh, this is gonna destroy a lot of farms. Okay, we're gonna take it around, loop it down, and make it come out right around here. Okay. So now, where am I gonna put this? Like, where the hell am I gonna put this? Let's put it right there. Right there. So here's what this is the experiment, okay? I'm gonna destroy that. I'm going to destroy... Oh, everybody lost power. Hold on a minute. Let me fix this. Can I make it go over? Like, I'm wondering, I don't know if I can do that or not. No, I can't. Okay. So hold on. Now I have to figure out how I want to get power from one side of the city to the other without breaking the line. Like that. That's how I can do it. There we go. See, I can always come up with a solution. Okay. Everybody's got power now, right? Everybody's got power. Okay. So again, I want to destroy that. Okay, so the residential, alright? The residential area of the city, both of them, they are completely cut off. They have no way of getting to the commercial areas or to the industrial areas, no way at all. Except for the civilian pathways, the pedestrian paths. So are they gonna use them? And this is what I wonder. I wonder if anybody's going to use them, because I just want to see them get some use, okay? I just want to see them get used. Let's speed things along. Now, the only real problem that I see with all of this is that, city services, like, you know, garbage pickup. Garbage pickup isn't really gonna be able to get into the residential areas. That's gonna be a problem. Now, see, look, lots of people are going... Yeah, a lot of people are going over to the commercial area. But you look at the little split here. Nobody's going the other way. Let's take a look. Where are they going? Well, they're coming out around there. You know what I bet they're doing? Yeah. they're getting in their cars. They're getting in their cars, and then they're gonna drive. They're gonna drive all the way over to their workplace. Okay. Hmm. Anyone making use of these pathways? Not really. Okay. Well, I guess we learned something, which is that if you have... I guess if you have pathways that are too long, nobody uses them. Even if there's no better alternative, like, even if there is no better alternative whatsoever, people just don't use them. What's everyone even doing around here? It looks like nobody's doing anything. They're not going anywhere. Lots of crime happening over here. But yeah, they're not using the pathway. Okay. Let's go ahead. Let's reconnect the path. I'll have to figure out another way. Alright, I'll have to figure out another way to get people to use those pathways. Eventually, I will figure it out. Okay, you know what? The other thing I could do is I could... Okay, so, like, I could make some commercial areas that are sort of in the way, right? Like, kind of, like, right around here, like, in the middle. I can make a big commercial area right in the middle. Because people seem to be willing to walk from, like... They're willing to walk over here. They're just not willing to walk that far. So, okay. Let's give them a reason. Let's give them some stops along the way. Alright? Okay. I'm going to expand on the residential areas a little bit. Not a whole lot, but, okay, gonna make some residential. A whole lot of residential, actually. Stretch that water out. Okay. So that solves one problem. Now, to get people to use the pedestrian paths, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna designate some more commercial space. And I'm gonna put it, like, right in the middle of these super long walkways. Although I know that I have all this junk right here, that's... Okay, that's a bit of a problem. Well, hold on a minute. We've got space right here. Right in the middle. We've got a whole bunch of space. Let's make use of it. Alright, so we're gonna make use of that small space right there. Gonna put some commercial all along here, and we're gonna make a pathway that goes down into there. This is horrible city planning. It's great if I can get it to line up. Oh, I can't do that. All right, let's take this down. No, that would get rid of that. That would get rid of that. Okay. Kinda hard to find a place where you can actually put a pathway down. Okay, I'm just gonna go ahead and delete some pathways because no one's really using them anyway, so, like, let's put this right here. Let's bring it down a little bit. Okay, That connects there. Wow, it seems like everything, if I want to connect it, it's going to destroy it. Okay, see, that doesn't destroy anything. Okay, there we go. So yeah, I'm gonna build this little commercial area right over in here, and hopefully, I don't know, hopefully they use it. Let me give them some incentives, like a bouncy castle. People love bouncy castles. There we go. Garbage is being a problem. Oh, we're almost full. The landfills are almost full. Okay, we've got power, we've got water. People aren't really moving into the areas that I created for them over here. So, I guess they want more jobs. Go ahead and supply them. So, are they using the pathways yet? I mean, I guess they're not really going to use the paths over there, because there's nothing there yet. There's no commerce there just yet. Now, let's see, are they using the other pathways? And what's all this? What's going on here? Not enough customers! So that's their problem over here. They just do not have enough customers. Well, are they using the walkway? Now they're using it. See, they're using the walkway up here. They're just not... Yeah, see, they're just not using the walkway on this side of it. Let's take a look if anyone is using it. Doesn't look like it. Yeah, no one's really using the walkway here yet. That's a shame. See, I feel like, you know, I've been enlightened about these wonderful pathways, and I want to make use of them, but I don't really know how. I don't really know how to most effectively make use of pathways. See, they're using it here, and I'm guessing that's because it's close enough. You know, let's go ahead and connect that. I guess people that want to walk, they'll walk. Yeah, I think that's the problem. It does kind of make sense because, like, okay, look, like, see, for this one right here, people are willing to use it, but for, like for this long pathway that extends, like, over the entire length of my city, yeah, no, it makes sense that nobody wants to use it because, well, why would you? I mean, you would literally be walking probably multiple days. Like, you would be walking for days just to get to your destination, and I'd imagine most people don't want to do that. So, I'll figure something out. Like, right here, okay? Oh, hey, look, people are using it now. Yeah, see, look at that. So, I put a pathway here, and people are actually using it now. Like, they're actually, Yeah, they're actually walking all the way from over here just to get there. That's wonderful. I need more population because I really I really, really want... I mean, like, I really want to get the garbage incinerator. We're almost there. Let's go ahead and build that out. I just need a few more people, and I'll be able to get some incineration going. Yeah, I wish I could force them to, though. Hey, look, I'm a benevolent mayor, okay? I just want to force all my people. Look, I'm keeping global warming down, all right? The solution is nobody gets a car, okay? No one has a car. Cars for no one. And you just... So, yeah, cars for no one. And then you just have to walk over this suspended death bridge to get to your destination. Right over top, just walk right next to the smokestacks from the oil and coal plants. You know, just waft it in. And if you make it to your destination, then you're doing good. You know, it doesn't kill you, it makes you stronger. Let's build this out a little bit more. And right about there. Okay. Oh wait, do they have water? They don't have water. Now they do. So garbage. Garbage is a big problem in this city, and I have to fix that. It's gonna take me a while to get on it. They got no more room. If I can just keep things going for a little while longer, just a little while. Like, if I can just kind of keep the city going long enough that it upgrades, then I won't have to worry. Unfortunately, it looks like garbage is really getting out of control. Happiness! Bouncy castles! Build more bouncy castles. People love bouncy castles. Or some parks. Either way is good. See, I think that everything can be solved with a bouncy castle. Okay, so people are happy again. Kind of, sort of, not really. People are moving out, like, a lot. I'm gonna have to build another, yeah, let's go ahead and build another garbage dump. Oh, look at this. I don't want to put it here, but I'm gonna have to. I'm gonna have to put the garbage dump right there. Okay, in the budget, let's go ahead and give all the money to garbage. Oh yeah, bike paths. I guess that would be another answer, but I love seeing people walking to their destination. Like, I can't help it. I really love to see people using these huge... Like, look at that. It always makes me happy to see, like, to see one guy, right? Like, to see one person just walking across this huge suspended bridge. Just that one guy. I love seeing it. I just love to see it, man. And look, see, they're biking. Look at that. See, they can totally bike on these paths if they want to. That guy's biking it up right there. Okay, I need to wait a little while. Let the garbage kind of, I have to let the garbage get collected. Also, I need to figure out what I'm gonna do with all the garbage. So, usually what I do is I designate, usually I designate a particular island as, like, the trash heap. And I just make that island just a center for garbage. I think this island right over here, I think that's going to be the garbage dump. So, like, what I'm going to do is I'm going to build this right here. Like, I'm just going to build, yeah, I'm just going to, like, in preparation. No, no, not a 4-lane. Yeah, we want a 6-lane. Okay. So, yeah, I'm going to designate this as the garbage dump. And so... how do I want to work this? Okay. I'm gonna have this road right here. I'm gonna have it kind of splinter off. And, okay, I'm gonna have this road go like this, okay? It's gonna go over... Yeah, it's gonna go over the highway. It's gonna go around like this, just very carefully. It's longer than I thought it was. There we go. That cost a lot of money. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put all of the garbage. It's all gonna be on this one island, okay? I gotta set this up in advance. Okay. Now, how the hell do I get the power lines over there? Oh, this is gonna be a problem. Okay, I'm gonna do like this, so... Go that way. That's gonna go over this way. And everything kinda connects around. Oh, this looks terrible. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm going to move all of the power plants away from the city, okay? Like, all the power plants are gonna be way off on this island over here. Eventually, not just yet, though. Not just yet. There's already something on the island. Can't quite tell what it is, but there's something over there. Huh. No, I got a handle on this, okay? I got a handle on it. Okay, so all the farms are going bankrupt. Why are they abandoning? Too much garbage. Well, I'm handling that. Okay, garbage is being handled very slowly. But it is being handled. Let's get rid of some of these abandoned buildings, because it's bringing property values down. Okay. Let me take care of some city services. They've got a hospital, right? Yeah, they got a hospital. I think they're okay. Oh, lots of dead bodies stacking up now. Oh, right. The cemetery. I don't know, the cemetery looks like it's doing fine. But let's build another one, I guess. Let's make another cemetery right there. Okay, so that'll kinda solve that problem. Let's get rid of some of the big offenders, right? Where lots of dead bodies are. Okay, and now we need residential, so there's finally a greater demand for residential housing. Let's go ahead and make another district. or, you know, a little, another little place where there's gonna be, you know, more people. Now, where do I want to put it? You know what? Let's put it right over here, because I've built all of this, like, I've built all this road that just goes off into the middle of nowhere. Well, hey, let's make it not the middle of nowhere. Yeah, look, we can totally fit a little community in right here. Alright, just... Yeah, look, we can put a community right around here, just plan it out. It'll be a real nice place to live. I'm just planning out a whole bunch of space now where I can build in the future. I'm not gonna do anything with it just yet. Just planning. The biggest of plans. And we'll get the water in right there. Stretch all that out. Everyone's got water. Power. How are they gonna get power? Well, we're gonna line the power in right there. Okay, so all of this is, it's pre-set up, it's all good to go. As a matter of fact, you know what, let's put some city services. Like, I'm confident enough that we're just gonna put a hospital, a fire department, a police department, all right there. And it looks like, guess what, there's a big demand for residential. So, let's just go ahead and do it. Now, I'm gonna hit the milestone very soon. Like, that big population milestone. Now I kinda wanna get some pathways going on here. So the biggest problem with pathways is they kind of cut off your power lines. So I'm like, okay, how am I gonna get power? How am I gonna get power over there? I don't know. Oh, we're a boom town now. Okay, let's start incinerating garbage. Okay, so now I'm going to move all the garbage out here. And it's gonna take a lot of garbage, like a lot of garbage management to get rid of all of this, so there we go. Unleash the garbage trucks. Unleash them. And so we're doing that now, so what I want to do is I want to, So yeah, we have the option of emptying the garbage to another facility, so let's do that. And let's do that. So yeah, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to start emptying out the, I'm gonna start emptying out the landfills. And so all the landfills, they're gonna send their garbage to, they're gonna send their garbage to the incineration plant. Yeah, there are subways. They're kind of expensive though. And, can I build them? Yeah, I can make a metro. Yeah, I do have the option to build a metro. But I've already built a whole city. Like, I've built a city based around railroads. I've built a city based around, subways. So for this city, I'm trying to make its overall theme to be pathways. So, like, I want people using those pathways. And let's go ahead and let's move all of the power plants out here. Gotta get him some water. Can never forget the water. Okay. So here we go. We're gonna move all the power plants right over to this island. And I'm doing that just to free up space so that I can start building more in the inner part of my city. That, and it'll make things look nicer. Like, right now I have this problem where there's just a big ugly cloud of smog right there. So once, yeah, once the landfills are emptied out, then I can start kind of moving, and I can start moving some proper, you know, industry and commercial areas in here. Also, our, look at this, see, people are using the pathways. All right, they are in fact making use of those pathways. That's what I like to see. That is what I like to see. Let's take a look at the power lines. Everything coming along with... Okay, everything's coming along with the power lines. So now... let's work on getting a pathway extended over here. So where am I going to put it? I'm going to put a pathway right here. Just get that pathway extended. There we go. Let's take it out over here. Let's go over the roads. I think I'll make it connect like right around here somewhere. Although I don't know. Okay, so this road right here. So look, I can't go over that, but I might be able to go under it. Let's see, that's not gonna be good enough. Here's what we'll do. We'll go like that. Kind of take it like that, and then we'll go right back up into the sky. Okay, so I can make like a power line going right over there. Yep, there we go. All right, so it looks a little ugly, but yeah, that'll allow people to get from the residential area here to, I don't know, the commercial area there, or the one right over here. It's a little bit awkward, but I feel like it'll work eventually. Now, in the meantime, I want to start planning for some more commerce. Yes, even more commerce. So, this area right up in here, that's all going to be businesses. And that's just kind of giving people more of a reason to take the pathway to get over here. Oh man, it's right next to the garbage dump. So that's why I want to get rid of the garbage dump. It's just, it's an eyesore. All right, I have the option of making some big residential now. Now, that's gonna really change the basic, like, how the game works, so I might want to be careful about that. Now, okay, is anyone gonna use this? I gotta know, is anyone using it? Oh, not yet. Not yet. Oh hey, I can buy another island. Maybe I'll buy this island down here. Maybe I'll buy that later. For right now, though, I think I want to expand maybe out this way. Or actually, I want to build a dam. So where would be a good spot for that? That's nearby. I don't really see any good spots. Oh wait, right here actually. I wouldn't have to buy anything at all. Can I make a dam? Not yet. So the fun part about building dams in this game is you can completely screw yourself over. I mean, like if you build a dam in the wrong spot, it'll just cause mass flooding and chaos all around. And that's, I love that. I want to create my own disasters. But you have to have a really deep running river. Like, you have to have a river that has a lot of water going through it, and I don't really think that any of the default maps, I don't think that any of them really have that kind of force to their rivers. And so that's what making your own maps is for. Yeah, people using this now. Wait, is this? Oh, look at that. It's an old man with a cane. Hey, look at that. It's just an old man with a walking cane. And he's making the trip. He's taking the iron challenge there. Okay, and let's see, are any people using the... No. No one is using the pathway here. So I have to put something interesting there. Like, I'll have to put a residential area, like right in here. Yeah, I think that might be a good idea, actually. Like, put a residential area right here. And that way, it would give people a reason to use the pathway, I think. Like right through here. Yeah, that man is an inspiration. I put him on the inspirational poster for this city. Hey, look, this old man can do it. Why don't you? Yeah, where's your patriotism, citizen? Man, now I just want to play SimCity Societies again. Because I want to... Like, now I want to make my super authoritarian city again. Man, I love that game. I can't help it. It's really not a very... I don't know. It's not a great city builder, but I love it. I just love it. Yeah, maybe another time. Alright, let's see. There's very low demand for everything, so... I don't know. Can't really build a whole lot. But I do have the option of upgrading to high density. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's put some high density right over here. Yeah, I'm just gonna zone some high density. Like, right around the pathways, actually. I want high density right where people are gonna be using those pathways. Just right there. Okay, so we're gonna start making the leap to high density, which I think that people in the high density buildings, I think they're less likely to have their own cars, so they're more likely to use, you know, the pathways. Let's fast forward. Oh, there we go. There's the first skyscraper. Alright, the very first skyscraper of Stremland. There it is. Now if I want people to use this pathway, I'm gonna have to put something interesting along the way, or I'm gonna have to put more people along the way, so they have a reason to use it. Oh, there we go, there's someone on the pathway. Alright, I mean, they're not getting a whole lot of use, but they are getting use. And I think that, like, for future reference, I think that if I want these pathways to really see a lot of use, then I think we have to make the pathways shorter. As in, like, well, okay, like, this pathway right here, like, the pathway between this residential area and this commercial area, that pathway actually gets a lot of play. And I think it's because the path isn't too long. So I think that's what I have to do, is I need to make my pathway shorter, or I just need to make more things along the way for people to, you know, to get on and off. Let's go ahead and make a little bit of residential. Not a whole lot, but just a little bit, like right here. Okay, I'm gonna make some residential there. Let me slow things down. Okay, so yeah, I'm gonna make residential all up in here, and I'm gonna make a pathway that also goes right down here. That's gonna break the power lines, that's fine. Here, let me pause the game while I figure out how I'm gonna do this. So, okay, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm going to take the walkway, and I'm gonna extend the walkway down here. Okay, I'm gonna extend it down right there. Okay, just make it connected there. So now you have the problem of, oh no, the power lines, they're not connecting. Well, I can solve that problem too. So you take the power lines and you elevate the power lines. All right, and then you make them connect like that. So, oh yeah, yeah, you can totally elevate power lines too. Did I not mention that? Yeah, you can make the power lines go up into the air. It's pretty awesome. Which, you know, since I can do that now, how about we do that over here so that we don't have to make the path go, you know, like on the ground. So let's just slow the simulation down. Let's make those, yeah, let's make the path go down there. And then let's make it connect back up here. And then let's make the power lines. Yeah, let's just make the power lines kind of go way, way up in the sky. Like right about there. It keeps wanting to build on the ground. Okay, so like that. Keep it elevated. Right like that. Okay. There we go. This looks terrible. It looks absolutely terribly amazing. Okay, so we got that figured out. Now let's build some residential, and I want to build... Yeah, I want to make dense residential right in here. And then the rest of it can be light residential. Okay. So yeah, now there's going to be like a little residential area, and people are going to be, basically, people are going to be getting on the pathway here, and they're going to be walking either to the industrial area, or they're going to be going to the little commercial area right here, or they might even be going, I don't know, somewhere over here. We'll build more stuff eventually. People want more industry, so let's go ahead and do that. Oh, look, those industrial lanes are getting all clogged up. You know, it's about time that I sort of expanded that. So let's go ahead. Let's upgrade the road to a medium road. And we'll just kind of have that medium road, like, yeah, we'll just have it extend all over here. Okay, that's good enough for now. Make sure everybody's got power. Yes, they do. Okay, let's get some more industry built. Well, actually, there's a whole bunch of industry that I can make right here. Let's go ahead and stretch that out. Make sure everything's got water. Okay. We need more garbage. more garbage. I demand more. Now, are those garbage dumps... Okay, the garbage dumps are still emptying out. Bit of a problem. Okay, there's gonna be a heightened demand for commercial. So, let's see. Yeah, I'm kind of building up some commerce, like, right around here. So, let's go ahead and expand on that a little bit. Like, not too much, but, like, I think right about here will do it. And I'm gonna build another pathway. I know, I gotta have those paths. Gotta have them path. Okay, so I'm just gonna make the pathway go, like right there. Come down here and, there we go. Just build up a little bit more commercial. Okay. They've got water, and they've got power. Okay. So I'm hoping that the pathways... Basically, I've been adding more kind of places for people to get on and off the pathways. So what I'm hoping is that people are actually going to be using them now. Like, oh, look at that, look at that. I just saw someone... Yep. So this person right here, Nancy Gray, they're the first foot traffic right here. And oh, they're not going to a shop. They're going to their job. So they're going to their job over here somewhere. Somewhere with the cows. So okay, look. Pedestrian paths, they work. They're a little awkward, but they work. Now all I have to do is I have to get rid of all of these garbage dumps. Yeah, these garbage dumps, they have got to go. Let's see, does everyone have... look at that, there's no police over here at all. That's not good. Let's go ahead and make a library, let's put a library right over here. They're not a library, it's an elementary school. Well, what am I thinking, this is Sim City or something? Okay, we've got a small city now. And that's good. Oh, I can make a hydro power plant now. And a train station. Excellent. I will not be doing that, not yet, anyway. Okay, is anyone using the pedestrian path over here? I gotta know. Is anyone using it yet? I'm gonna guess no. Like, if I had to guess, I would say no. Well, people want more commerce, though. So I'm going to expand the commercial area a little bit. Hold on, let me think how I want to expand this. Okay, I'm gonna expand it, like, right along the road here. Oh, there we go. And I'm just gonna make it connect right there. Okay, I'm kind of expanding on the commercial area around the city. And you know what? I might even... Like, look, hey, why not? I'll build some residential right there. Why not? But what I want to do, primarily, is I want to get a pathway going down in there. So, I want to put, like, a path... Let's see, here's a good extension for it, like right here, and bring that pathway down, right into this area, right here. And then because I'm doing that, I have to make the power lines elevated. Because of course I do. There we go. So, okay, now there's, yeah, the pedestrian path. See, look at that. There's a happy shopper coming home. So, okay. Now more people are going to use the pathway. All right, well, get you some of those upgrades, Burn. And, yeah, that kind of reminds me, it's, honestly, I probably need to upgrade my computer. I've had this one for like 4 years or so now, and it wasn't a high-end thing when I bought it. It really wasn't. What I've got is more of a console PC, really. And yeah, now that I'm streaming too, like I can run like games like this. I can run games like this on maximum settings on my own, but when I stream, I have to tone things down. And I have to do that a lot with some of the more modern games that I stream. So I really do need to, at some point, upgrade. Just so I can, you know, make things look nice while I'm streaming it. Oh man, the bikers, they're using the pathways, I love it. But anyway, it's a long way away from that. Yeah, as much as I do love those little, you know, donations and everything, but it's gonna take more than a couple dollars here and there to make that kind of an upgrade. For right now, that money just goes towards getting some games when I see them on sale, and I think they might be good for the stream. That's like if anyone ever wonders like what all that what does Double do with that, you know, all that amazing internet money, right? Those multiple dollars. Well, that's what. It's mostly for games that I'm going to be playing on the stream. You know, all those multiple dollars put to use. Oh man, I love this. I love seeing all the little people going along the illuminated pathways. Let's see, are people actually using them? Like, are they using the whole length of the pathway? That's what I wonder. Well, people are going over here. And I know that I saw people coming from this area over here. So yeah, people are using the pathways. Not a whole lot, but they are using them. And I love to see it. I love to see people using those paths. Love to see someone biking along there. Even over this crazy huge stretch of road right here, they're still using it. Well, you know, when it comes to the suggested settings and all that, yeah, that kind of reminds me back in the day. I'm talking like mid-90s. This was a problem I ran into a lot with, you know, PC gaming, and it's why I never really committed to it. But, like, back in the mid-90s, like, games, they'd always have, like, the suggested settings, you know, like, what you need to play the game. And you'd never meet them, because, man, like, the hardware components back then were so rare. There were so, you know, they're like 5,000 different, you know, producers of graphics cards and RAM and all that, so... So basically, you would never really meet the exact requirements that they wanted you to have. So it was kind of a gamble as to whether or not a game would actually play or not. Even if you had, like, a good computer. And back in the day, like, you'd upgrade your computer just to play one game, and then, like, a couple months later, you would upgrade again just to play a different one because of how that worked. Oh man, it's not so bad these days. You know, things have kind of slowed down, and honestly, for the consumer, that's better. It's good that things have slowed down. I'm just gonna make a little bit of residential, just, you know, all dotted along here. So let's see, my power... gonna need more power soon. And actually... let's go ahead and... well, hold on, I have this ability to build a dam. Why not? Let's make a dam. Let's make a gigantic dam. Let me save, you know, so I got insurance, right? So where do I want to build a dam? Also, how's my water doing? Oh, water is not doing so great. Okay, so another water pump. And another sludge pump. There we go. You know what I think I should do? I think I should move the sludge pumps so that they're not pumping so close to land, because, like, look at that. I think the better thing to do is, once I have the option, I think I should, like, I should buy up that island right there. Man, I should do it right now, actually. Yeah, like, I should buy that island right there and start dumping from there. That way, like, there's no contamination in this area right here. It'll all just go straight out into the ocean with no water flow to, like, push it around. Because you have to, like, see, you have to deal with water flow, and... yeah, like, there's almost no water flow right around here. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's buy up that land. Okay, so we're gonna buy up the land, and we're gonna start sludge pumping, like, right around here. See, perfectly safe, just dumping, you know, just dumping all of our garbage straight into the ocean where it's nice and safe, and there's absolutely no concerns about that at all. Okay, let's get rid of these things. And I don't need that anymore. Okay. So yeah, look at that. Now we're... yeah, all the sludge is gonna come right out of here. So we don't have to worry about it polluting up this nice area near the city. Yeah, that's prime real estate there. That's beachfront property. Don't want to ruin that. Okay, so how about that dam? Let's save again, and let's work on a dam. So, where would be a good spot? There's some good water flow right along here. Lots of real good water flow coming in there. I kind of want to make a dam right here, because this just seems like a good spot. Like right here, what's the worst that could happen? And let's just connect it to the power. Hold on. Just connect it to the power. There we go. Okay, so how's this gonna work out for me? Let's fast forward and let's see what happens. You have to kind of wait a little while to see, like, sometimes it doesn't have the desired result. No, I think this is going to work out just fine. It has zero power output so far. That's a problem. Why does it have zero power output? It should be making power, like, right now. But it's not. Hmm. Yeah, it's not making any power whatsoever. It's just kind of clogging up the river. Well, that's a problem. Let's load. That's why I always save my game before I build a dam. Because it never works out the way you want it to. Never. Okay. So when it comes to power, I'm just gonna stick to... just gonna stick to coal and oil. I know, they might not be the most environmentally friendly. You know, they might not be the best for Mother Nature, as it were. But they're very efficient. What can I say? Let's get some more incineration going. I feel like I need even more garbage than this. Yeah, all these things, they're working hard. Okay. So when it comes to... yeah, when it comes to the main city here, I think everything's doing okay. The landfill is still emptying out. I'm trying to empty out both the landfills, and once they're emptied out, I can get rid of them, and then I can make... I can make something there. Also, there's another problem, and that is the cemeteries. The cemeteries are eventually going to fill up. And when the cemeteries fill up, then they become a completely useless plot of land. A rather large, useless plot of land. So... the next thing I want to work towards is I want to work towards not a sauna. I want to work towards a crematorium. So once I have a crematorium, then I can start emptying out the cemeteries, you know, just like I did with the landfills and the incinerators. Well, you can do the same thing for cemeteries and crematoriums. Just start digging up bodies and shoveling them right into the crematorium, which, you know, moral implications abound, but it's how you save space. And let's start building out our little areas here. So, all that, it's all gonna be dense. Start moving up to dense residential. So with the dense residential, we're gonna get more people walking, you know, less people owning their own car. So that's gonna be great for the pedestrian paths. Like, more people are gonna be using those, and as such, yeah, I'll feel completely validated in building this gigantic, cumbersome, you know, elevated pathway system, right? I mean, look, I like the look of it. I love watching people going about their business on these elevated pathways. I mean, man, just imagine, it'd be like, it's a great, if you want to commit a crime up there, I mean, you got all this space to throw somebody off the side, or if you want to jump, I mean, oh, that's, man, all the safety hazards. I mean, these things are basically death bridges. That's what they are. They are death bridges. But I think they look cool, and I like seeing people use them. I love seeing people walk 5 miles to get from their house to the nearest convenience store. I love seeing that. And see, they're making use of it, and they are all making proper use out of these pathways. Oh man, Roller Coaster Tycoon! You know, I loved that game. I loved the first Roller Coaster Tycoon, and the second one as well. I played the hell out of those back in the day. And I tried to get into the more modern Roller Coaster Tycoons, and I couldn't do it. I don't know why. All my money's going in the deficit. What are we missing out on here? We got so much power. You know what? I got so much power. Let's go ahead and shut down one of those oil power plants. That'll get our money back. Let's bring it back online. There are 1,920 a week. That's why it's costing me so much money. Well, I could start bulldozing some things. I don't know. We'll see about that. Yeah, for me, that was like the most fun for me was, yes, of course, making death coasters and also making like entrapments where people couldn't get out. And you just have a bunch of people trapped in part of the park. And then you'd have people just dying all the time. That's the exact wrong way to play the game. But it's the most fun way to play the game. Like, just the most fun way to play the game. I can't help it. It's like, there's another game, Wildlife Park Tycoon, or I think it might just be called Wildlife Park. But it basically does what Roller Coaster Tycoon did, but for parks, like for zoos, basically. And, you know, I have the most fun in that game by making really terrible enclosures that people can just walk into, and then just seeing the animals just tear the shit out of the tourists, just eat them up. And that game, like Wildlife Park 2, that game has it has an expansion for it, which is basically dinosaurs. You can literally make your own Jurassic Park. And so what I would do is I would make Jurassic Park, and then I would just start tearing down the fences and just let the T-Rex run wild, let the Velociraptors just run down the walkways, just hopping on people and killing them. And like, that's how I played that game. I don't know what it is, but when it comes to park games, like tycoon games, I just love playing them badly. What can I say? It's fun. You know, I got this whole big island here. So, you know what I think I want to do? I mean, if we've got this big island and we're not really doing a whole lot with it, let's start making some industry, right? Let's start cramming some industry in this place. Okay, so I'm gonna start building industry over on this island. Just start completely destroying the ecosystem, right? Like, look at that, all that oil just shooting off into the ocean, harmlessly off into the ocean. They want even more industry. God damn it. Like, what am I gonna do with all this? How's our power doing? Okay, what I think I want to do is I want to bring this power plant online. Okay, yeah, I want to bring that one online, and then I just want to get rid of one of the coal power plants. Just one of them. Or actually... No, actually, let's go ahead and get rid of both of them. No. Some coal power is good. Okay, there we go. This is burning down now. And they want more residential, so I'm gonna go ahead and tear some things down. just gonna tear down some of these low, some of these light residentials and replace them with dense residential. That way, you know, just get a lot of people moving in. I can just build up instead of building out constantly. Power's good, water's good, healthcare is okay. Fire safety looks like it could use some work. Oh, right. Now that I'm building over here, I'm probably gonna want to have some services around here. Okay, I'll just build one fire station for right now. Oh man, they want even more industry. Well, if the people demand it, then who am I not to give it to them, right? There we go. Oh, they need water. I always forget the water. It's every time you zone out something new, it's like, oh yeah, right. You gotta actually, you know, they have to have some water and electricity and all that. Okay. So yeah, this island is coming along quite nicely. Ooh, that's a lot of traffic. I can see all the traffic over here. Now, hopefully, people start using... Like, hopefully they start using the pathways a little bit more. I am seeing a bit more traffic. As I start building up the more dense residential areas, I'm starting to notice a little bit more traffic coming through there. So, let's go ahead and dezone all of this and then rezone it. Just dezone and rezone. Okay. And I'm gonna do that for a couple other areas, and yeah. See, just gonna do that here and there, just kind of make sure that people have, you know, some houses to move into. I'm dezoning a little bit too hard now. Yeah, I accidentally destroyed a bunch of houses. That's okay. That is okay. Oh, commerce. They want some of that commerce now. And I can actually start building high-density commercial. Don't know if I want to do that, though. Let's do like a trial run, okay? Like, just make a tiny little area of high-density. Just to kind of make sure and, you know, see if it works out, make sure it doesn't upset the economy, the balance of the economy. People using the path over here? A little bit. I just like to make sure people... And look at this! Look at this! Some people are actually walking along the side of the road. That is just... I make these nice... I make these glorious pathways elevated above the city. And they want to go ahead and use the regular old sidewalks. I mean, come on. Come the fuck on. Let's work on some more industry. This island is going to be a polluted mess very soon. Like, very soon, this island is not going to be... It's not going to be survivable. Like, human beings are not going to be able to breathe the air on this island very soon. Oh, Oh, we got new buildings, but I'm not gonna worry about that. Not yet. Oh, now they want... Oh, look at that. I built a bunch of industry, and now they want tons of residential, too. Okay, let's go ahead and do it. How do I want to plan this out? Well, I guess let's dezone all of this and then very quickly rezone it. Okay, so that'll be a whole big section of dense residential. See, when you hit a certain point, like you hit like a, you know, you hit a good stride in the game, and then you can just kind of do whatever you want. I think I've kind of hit that point already with this city, and I can just start building and just doing whatever I want now. I kind of like the early parts of the game where you're struggling just to get basic, you know, basic demands met. I mean, to me, that's kind of one of the most fun parts of any game, and I feel like maybe I might be alone in thinking this, but whether it's a city builder, or it's an action game, or an RPG, or whatever, I always feel like the early game is the most fun. Like, I have the most fun when I don't know what I'm doing, when everything could fall apart at any moment for any reason, and you're just kind of struggling to get by. I feel like that's the most fun in any game. Like, no matter what genre of game it is. Let's go ahead and... Yep. Dense residential. And I think I'm gonna build a little bit more dense residential up over here, and that'll be all for right now, as far as rezoning goes. Let's make a little bit more dense commercial. Just a little bit. Oh man, all the dense commercial just all went bankrupt. Worker education is too low. So you know what that means. I'm gonna have to build a high school. Okay, where can I build one safely? Yeah, let's make a high school right over here. Boom, it makes everybody happy. Everybody loves education. Oh, hold on. I fucked up the placement. There we go. And now I need to make some more sludge. Need to pump a little bit more sludge out into the ocean. Okay. Just safely polluting the ocean. No worry about that at all. Now, there's a lot of sludge right here, and it's not going away, and that kind of worries me. But hey, let's not worry about it, right? That's a lot of traffic. That is a whole lot of traffic. Okay, they want more commercial, they want more. People want, they want more of everything. I can't build it all fast enough. Okay, you know what? Let's go ahead and just complete overhaul. Alright, that whole area. all of it gonna be dense residential. Just pack as many people in there as we can. Also, are these paths getting any... Again, I always have to check. I gotta know, are the pathways getting some use? Are they getting a little bit of play, right? A little bit. Not a whole lot, but a little. Now these... Yeah, these pathways are getting some more use than they were. The city is coming along quite nicely. Yeah, you can see that, you can see that sludge even. It's like it glows in the dark. It's great. Oh, that's just the pharmaceuticals that we put in the water supply. Makes everyone's shit glow. So all they want right now is they want more commerce, and I can do that. I am happy to provide. Let me just think about where I want to do that. I guess right in here would be a good spot. Just kind of like right around here. There we go. That really doesn't give a whole lot of space, but it's something. And make sure they got water. Okay. Now there's all these burned down buildings. I should probably address that. How about a fire station? Let's put a fire station like right in the middle of town. Although, I don't think I have the money for that. Yeah, that's a lot of money. That's a lot of weekly money right there. I mean, I guess I can afford it, but kinda not really. I don't know. Yeah, let's put one right there. It'll make the whole city happier. Hey, look at that. Just wave of happiness all across the city. And while we're at that, let's go ahead and add some more happiness-boosting things, like bouncy castles. Everybody loves bouncy castles. I've never seen anyone that doesn't like a bouncy castle. So there you go. A couple of extra bouncy castles. And that'll just make everyone... It doesn't... You know, all their problems just go away. Alright? The magic of the bouncy castle makes all of their urban problems go away. There, three bouncy castles, and it's all good. See, look, it's bouncing! It's bouncing! No, they got no water. That's not good. So why is my water availability going down so fast? Power. That's why. Oh god, that's why. Hold on a minute. How can I fix this? How can I fix this? Well, I see the problem right here. There isn't enough oil being supplied to the oil and coal power plants. There's just not enough power going around. That's a problem. If I move the buildings, maybe we can move the buildings to an area that has a little bit more, what's the word? I don't know. Like, okay, if we move all these buildings to a place where they're a little bit more, I guess where they have better access to, like, you know, the power, to the actual, like, you know, to the actual buildings that are gonna give them their resources. It's like a little closer to the center of town. Yeah, let's do that. So I'm gonna move all the power plants over there. I know I wanted to put them all on this island, and I like that island, but yeah, no, let's move them all straight into the middle of town again. Oh, I don't have enough money to do that. Damn. Well, let's see if they get their fuel. Let's see if they get their fuel now. Power is very spotty. Oh, that's not good. That's really not good. There's just not enough power to go around. Let's fast forward. Okay, you know what I might have to do? Okay, what I might have to do is I might have to start putting like these windmill power things out there. They don't run out of oil. That's kind of the thing. They don't run out of oil, unlike certain other power supplies. So as a matter of fact, I'm gonna take out a loan. Yeah, I'm gonna take out a 60,000 loan, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start building I'm gonna start building these little power thingies. I'm gonna start building those. They give like 20 megawatts each, so they work, okay? They work, they're good power. Let's just start building those. Not enough money. Okay. Kinda figured that's what would happen. So let's start getting rid of, like, this giant polluting oil power plant. Let's get rid of that. And we still have power. We still have plenty of power. So let's go ahead and build another one of these. Okay, yep, see, look, I got plenty of power still. Let's go ahead and get rid of the other oil power plant. That puts us dangerously low, but we're still doing good. So I'm gonna go ahead and take out another loan. Alright. And we're just gonna build some more of these little things right along here. Okay. See, we're doing good. We're doing good. Get a little bit more power going on. Okay, so pretty soon, we're not going to be reliant on coal or oil or anything like that. We're going to have our own magical, renewable energy, perfectly clean. Let's go ahead and get rid of this last power plant. And that actually frees up a lot of money as well. So, yeah. So now, let me just build a couple more of these, because you have to build a lot of them to compensate for all of the power you lose from the coal and oil power plants. There we go. So we now have all of the power that we need. Okay? All the power we need. And it's clean. That's another great thing, right? Is that all this energy is 100% clean. Don't worry, it's all good. Basically. Let me make sure the power actually gets... Hey, let's make sure the power actually gets out here. So we're just gonna stretch that out. Right about to there. Okay. Just in case the power lines don't quite match up. You know? Alright, I think we're good for power. So yeah, I've turned around from my my polluting ways. Although, man, oh, that's some pollution going on there. That water looks terrible. I wonder how far out into the ocean that's gonna go. Like, I wonder if I just leave it, if, you know, like, when the game year is, like, 22, if, like, I'm gonna come back and all of the, like, just the entire ocean and everything is just brown, right? Well, that's a, yeah, that's a problem for future generations of mayors. Not my problem. Okay, there's a huge demand for an industry right now. Like, I mean, they really want that industry. Badly. Extend these roads out. Looks good to me, and make sure there's water for everyone. Just making sure there's water, that every inch of the place is covered. And now, let's start building lots of industry. Because, I don't know, they want lots of industry, so let's do it. I guess, not too much, though. I guess you start building too much, and that's a problem. And then they'll want more residential, and it just keeps coming back around. It never ends. It never ends. But, yeah, speaking of never ending, so let me just do one last check, make sure everything, yeah, we're pretty good on all of our resources, and everything's doing good. The city could be better, but it's doing half decent. I'm gonna save it here, and I think we're good for right here, right now, today. The main thing that I wanted to do, like the main experiment of this city, was pathways. I wanted to see how pathways would work out. Like elevated pathways, like pathways that, you know, go all over the city and, you know, people would be using them instead of driving. Well, it doesn't quite work out that way. You still have to have roads. You still have to have roads for services and all that. So that was kind of a pipe dream. But people are using these elevated pathways. Okay, like these elevated pathways, people are using them. They are walking and cycling all over the place. They're going from their homes to their businesses to their jobs. They're going all over the place with these. They're like, people are using the elevated walkways that I've made. Like, they are making use of them. So it's a semi-success. Yeah, it kinda works, kinda doesn't. It was a fun little experiment either way. Anyhow, I think I'll leave it on that. It's a nice little overview of the city, how it's come this past 3 hours. So, alright. That's enough for this for today. I hope that it's enjoyable to someone. I always like, I always find these to be very relaxing, very zen. And at the same time, it's a great time to just talk. So, again, only other thing today is later tonight, I will be, as I've been doing for the past couple of days, I will be continuing the Vampire the Masquerade playthrough. You know, I'll be continuing on with Bloodlines, and I'm not sure, you know, I'm probably not going to finish up downtown. I'll try to, but I'm probably not going to finish that section of the game up tonight. And, one other thing. I'm actually going to kind of, sort of script it. I'm kind of working on a, I'm still trying to get people interested in the tabletop game, and so I feel like maybe a 2-hour-long stream explaining the game, I feel like maybe that's a bit overwhelming. So for the recruitment on my YouTube channel, which people do check it out every now and then, I'm going to make a very short, to the point, 10 minutes or less video where I basically will explain the game, what it's about, and more specifically, the details, like contact information, what you'll need to play, all that good stuff. I'm gonna condense it all down into a very short video. I'm gonna work on recording that right after I finish here, and I'll have it up on the channel soon. Soon, trademark. So yeah, and also, anyone that might have just tuned in, sorry, you missed it. There's always, every single time I go to conclude the stream, I always see the view count go up, people just getting in. I'm sorry, what can I say? I've been here for 3 hours. I've been streaming, but you missed it. Better luck next time. So, yeah. That's what I got planned for today. Try to get on that. Hope to see some people around for the next stream later tonight. Man, I fucked this city up good. Just look at all that pollution going into the ocean. Alright, so, yeah, thanks for coming. See you all later. Bye.